Which is So, Yeah, we need to have a good story model, but that's also about formally taking the information. We didn't actually have any time to talk about that. So we're generally pretty talking from bottom to the not very good. But that's a whole different story. So I see the problem that's the so one way to first think about the story model is that we're sort of doing a very weird one of our questions like this. So what we've been saying is by optimizing the law is to get a point estimate, to get a single value theta, which is basically the dimension of the estimate. So that sort of points to sort of a difference in a lot of what we would use for us to say, which is for each set of objects or some data, we can have to give it a form of objects that might be kind of being stressed. You're getting a point estimate from the object that you plan to set that version. So only this is not an emotional process. So for every observation happening, we have to read what the observation. So this is not the process. But it's particularly important for the materials, for instance, where we're trying to combine smart measurements to get a 3D model or a multi-dimensional model of the process. So there's the expectation of the input that we do. So, a range that's different from position to the object, and from the study of three reports that combine that to form a three problem. And now, general investors, I'm afraid that that's also done with a block for the century. So, there's a step to what it is, but what's actually that all of these inputs are spatial temporal signals, which is the difference between the two. So, we just call that all. So we need to do a calculation and have to report up into a single range of different angles that are the so, the number of times we can put a solution in the color of Okay, so now we have more networks. What we have is the more of the networks that we have. We're going to try to come up with what we're going to do is to compress that and combine it with the reason why the system was in trouble. So it's sort of comes into a neural representation of it. And then also, what I'm Thank you. on the general principle of that. So, I start with, I think, based on the importance of our approach. There's some way to make it work, and I think it's an input, and it's an output, which is something that we can start with, and I think that the domain of input is going to be used to talk about the problem, and we have a book written for some of the reading colleges. That's not necessarily the benefit, because at this point, it's the density of the function 3D, that's something we measure, that's something we're trying to model. So we need to connect the 3D model and the sort of reconstruction domain with our own domain, and how we do that is with the template. So we want to do that with the sort of forward model, but they need to get them to bring up the data method to complete the systems of the model. Then that allows you to get what looks like an interesting concept of an information model. And so this is what you can measure in the picture. This is what we want to do to start from the 3D model, and the thing that connects the two is our different tools in the so it's not just rendering, there's also for building pictures of objects that we want to sort of take on a point forward and connect the objects that we want to take simplification to the function coming with them, which are related to what we actually see through the way that the story is transformed. So you can see that holding that person to the demography, what you're basically getting at are slightly more of this image and also a lot of the way that transformation. And I want to use it slightly that the real functions that we want to reconstruct from the first one. So, this is a differential difficulty of rendering. We're really actually one step in the equation to the color of the integral, whereas in here, we can see the velocity of the other things that are information about the density of the other things that are along the red. I think much more than a minute, we just sort of general framework. We've got a neural network modeling from the construction domain to connect with the sensors and the actual simulator. You can even think about that framework for things like detection of labor. So I might be able to do accurate simulation of the differential equation solver or the differential solver, and then I want to model those differential equations in the network. If you want them just fitted in the network, and there are a few experiments on the purpose of studies. So this is an optimization where it comes to you might have a load bearing in the equipment, and you might have to take the best of a load of structure. So you might be doing some stuff in the construction, but a bunch of pieces of reconstructed can actually be calculated with computer science. The model energy, the information that can be propagated to the density of the structure, or the way we can reasonably model the signal or the dimension of the signal. So, given the information level, we can set the right to be included from, for instance, our electron study in the instrument direction, you want to be able to predict the density of the signal rather than the potential of the signal. So, what's the overall okay, so there's a lot of applications we just do in more detail later, but hopefully we've learned a little bit of the structure of this as we model. So it depends on what I do. So the graphics is a little bit tough because the way that order is, when you say, you can actually take graphics out of the text, you can see one of them is probably the other. And we're not operating like those two things that are simple to make sure you're just a separate kind of feature to make sure that we're just responding to some of the strategy that it can be better to the sort of frequency of the information. So sometimes we do a sort of you can imagine the sort of you can imagine before you send from the call and call to the CDR on the phone. So, the example of that is usually before you send from the call to signal, that's it. Something before you send from the call to the call to the call. So, you can try to think about it like this for a feature before you send from the call out and the call to the call to the call to the call. But it comes out of the market and just comes yes, we do have more separately. We can do that. We can do that. We do that. So this is actually what's the point to do one. Okay. So a simple and even if it's a downside of all those things, and what you're trying to find out is how much variability you have in the imagery of the model of different structures and different systems. So what we can do is see that maybe something that's called the range of that system is how well you're looking at the cost of the value of the system. So all those things that you can do, and all those things that you can do, and all those things that you can do, and so what we're thinking about is what we're thinking about is the temporary effect of what this means to us in order to be talking about. Given a bunch of data that they can see all the models of variability and how to do that data with the stuff that comes. Whereas other models that come up, they're not able to really predict lots of variables that can be different types of things. Okay. So, a few points on the field, why it's all interesting. So, one of the things we're modeling signals without physically specified real estate, so that people have to take different people to search through, to be close on the baseline. Yeah. So basically, we can be much more than one person with a nice word. And there's a sort of continuous way to combine multiple, so why the bunch of sentences is to really take the right people. The combination of those should have a better way of doing that. Anytime you choose a model for the data, you specify a set of functions to the model. In this case, we're choosing a real number of steps. We're going to say the tuning has to be within the space of functions that have been networked in all of this for some identity. But that's not what we're going to do. We're going to do that for the first function. So the question is regulated. The total power comes from the poison. I think you can prove that you have a bit of trouble. I think you can prove that by using the four properties in the system, I think you can probably prove that a certain box of space, you put a function and a neural network with something like that, and that is how that function is going to be part of the circle. That being said, with a finite set of data, you also have to deal with what's called the data cost. Thank you. But that is visible between two crosses and the effect of the time, as opposed to the other two things. But, in the case of this sort of wiggling between the two crosses, suddenly you have a time that goes on. But like the cross is going to be a change, and you also have a sense of resistance to change the change. So, the question of energy is a big problem, the question of property energy is quite space. It's actually a change of time. So, what you're basically saying is that the space is just a free to take up a combination of time and the space. And that is why we have to have the utility of the clock, and that's because there are times in the stress of the experimental effect, where you basically want to do all of these facades and all sort of things like the stress of the so that's sort of what these systems look like. These are two of the broad selection systems. But they're sequence, the combination of sequence. And what we find is that the different limitations to the sequence of the letters can be shortened according to the situation of the system. And it's also related to the different systems. So there's two ways that one might be as you turn to the right of the finger that cross that are checked in, and that's effectively what you have to do also with both my side, where you put two balls in there, but you have to do the left of the piece to do both my interface, also the smaller crossing away. And this crossing away interaction with the electron effectively looks like it has a way to or, of course, you can get rid of the electrical system to take care of the yeah. Oh, right. So, you're always measuring. You're measuring the useful function. What you still need to measure is some measure of how long it's taking. How much longer it takes to measure that. So you can just ignore this law, keep going, and it's better. You don't know if the actor can be changing over time. But what happens if the baby is just like, that's going to be something over time, or whatever legal, like how we get the training like that. Like these law are going to cause some different disasters. But if I tell you there's a wiggle that's going to be the same on the top and the bottom, then I know that it's not the wiggle on the bottom side. But the top side is bigger than our gravitational wave. So the gravitational wave is going to explicitly affect the space of the system. So that's going to be the difference in the way that they can just do it. More than a meter separation of the next site of the graph that you're going to be able to do Google search. is in between what we said and what I said, so it's a nice middle ground. And also, we go from that just 100 to a kilometer of paper, which actually provides 200 power there. And of course, you can take it from these spaces and get rid of a lot of gravity. So that might be the goal of the we can sort of take some target measures and then follow the analysis that was made with the FDA's block and optimize it for the ones that are in the test. So, we can take the round to formulate the data that we need to be able to do the best of the work that we can do the best of the work that we can do. So, we do include it. In the picture of the way, this is that we have practiced gray, and we project on the series of 160 the target for the mission data is blue, red, from and it comes out the same together, we would say, the information of about 65 times is created, as the question may go away from the cause to be a total of the findings. So, this is some of these papers. One of the things we did do, which is opposed to because we did put a little 3D print out with a we can actually reconstruct that 3D object from the 3D object with a bunch of images, which are real images of the object. Then we reconstruct it with sort of ordinary images and camera functions. So these are what we can reconstruct it and actually do that. So we're able to reconstruct the function and we can sort of figure out what that is. So we 3D printed it and it's actually so we can also see there's a blue button going through this thing that's actually a patient why we use the whole of the space plate. So we actually can get a lot of resolution on the simple picture. Okay, so that is our 3D reconstructed object for we have one more application, and then we'll have to close the okay. First, another application is for the young application, so, in the young application, our goal is to we have some customers that are trying to create the device for the function. We want to basically go to the detector that we can send one of the RAM functions to say, if you use the subscript, it's up to the resolution, 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 the probability basically is that the probability of particles lost is basically what the system is. Given a system space, there's going to be the probability of the system is infinite. So that basically is coming, that's the probability of the fraction, basically coming from the system. There's some probability of the system. When you can sort of think about that, it's kind of sort of a simulation of the one that's left. So the fun experiment that we can do is that instead of basically writing down the performance of the object with a 3.5 of the radiation, what if instead of doing that, we just model the detector with a set for the whole, which is the amount of material space is going to be given up to the space, and now that we have enough time to see the material density, the probability that we're after that is constant. So we're going to plug in this a little bit. So, we can still, and then try to optimize the system. So, this is a picture of the graph. Given time and space, we can out of the system with computer systems. And so what we're really sort of doing is coupling together the neural network and physics code and sort of joint optimizing the whole system together. And that's part of another feature of how we include physics information to the network system. You can almost think about all that physics code as another layer of network economics, where the physics code is getting valuable when it comes to the network system. And in fact, we just get the data for prediction for the network. So in some sense, So right now we're trying to reach a problem that we're calling the problem. So we're trying to answer the question of the problem. We've taken on a multi-user system. We've taken on a cloud to develop a system that first makes a bunch of 3D outcomes. The second thing that we're working on is the